Hi everyone, Joshua here with Barista Warehouse, and today we're making stovetop espresso using Bialetti's Moka Alpina. This is a very unique looking moka pot styled after the Cappello Alpino, a recognizable hat worn by Italy's Alpine Corps, which is the world's longest standing mountain infantry. This easy to use, simple stovetop espresso maker is made from aluminium, so it's gonna work on gas and electric stovetops only. And if you wanna shop the Moka Alpina, you can by following this link right here. Let's jump straight in now though and begin brewing using it. Like every Bialetti Moka pot, they come apart in three pieces. We have the water chamber. This we fill with cold water to just below the pressure valve. In this case, it's around 160 mils. Next, we have the grinds basket. A simple way to get the right amount of coffee each time you brew here is to fill this up with beans first and then grind them out. Though, if you are weighing them, it'll take around 20 grams. Grind them to a medium fine grind size, and in filling the basket up, don't overfill the basket or tamp the grinds down too hard, but do ensure there aren't any grounds around the top of the basket before placing it in on top of the water chamber. Then screw the top brew chamber onto this and place it on the stove on a low to medium heat. Now, you don't want that water to boil too fast, as this will produce a bitter coffee. So I'm aiming for a heat that lets the pressure gradually rise, and then the water will slowly percolate through that bed of coffee. And I'm using Bialetti's induction compatible plate, and this allows me to use aluminium moka pots on an induction cooker. I'm gonna throw a link up above for that one. It should take a total of 4 to 5 minutes to finish brewing. It will start off slow and then speed up at the end, and you'll absolutely know it's done as that water will begin spurting out. Now, don't leave it on the stove here too long, but turn off your heat, remove the brewer, and then pour the freshly brewed coffee straight out into your cups. Now, whilst it does say that it is a 3-cup brewer, that's essentially only 90 mils of brewed coffee. So I wouldn't count on it actually making 3 full cups of coffee. It's a good size for 1 or 2 not so strong coffees. I certainly enjoy drinking my coffee straight black as an espresso, but I highly recommend you checking out the Bellman 50SS as a stovetop steamer that works fantastic in combination with any moka pot, and the link's right here. Now, this is going to texture milk if you want to turn these espressos into cappuccinos or lattes. In cleaning the unit, wait for it to cool down before unscrewing the top, remove that filter basket, and then tap those grinds out. Rinse everything underwater. You can use a little bit of detergent here as well. It's really important though to give the brewer a thorough dry before placing it back together. That way you avoid any oxidization of the aluminium. And that's the Bialetti Moka Alpina for you. It's a popular model for its interesting design. I'd hoped somehow that that little feather had something to do with letting you know when the coffee had finished brewing. That's not the case, but it still does make a delicious stovetop espresso, and I'd say it's even small enough to be worthy of a travel-friendly brewer. Now, if you have any questions on the Bialetti Moka Alpina, throw them in the comments section down below and we'll get straight back to you. Don't forget to hit that little bell icon on your screen, and then that way you stay notified when we bring out new videos just like this every week. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.